HIV continues to be a major global public health issue, having claimed more than 35 million lives so far. In 2016, 1.0 million people died from HIV-related causes globally. There were approximately 36.7 million people living with HIV at the end of 2016, with 1.8 million people becoming newly infected in 2016 globally. 54% of adults and 43% of children living with HIV are currently receiving lifelong antiretroviral therapy, ART. Global ART coverage for pregnant and breastfeeding women living with HIV is high at 76%. The WHO African region is the most affected region, with 25.6 million people living with HIV in 2016. The African region also accounts for almost two-thirds of the global total of new HIV infections. HIV infection is often diagnosed through rapid diagnostic tests, RDTs, which detect the presence or absence of HIV antibodies. Most often these tests provide same-day test results, which are essential for same-day diagnosis in early treatment and care. Key populations are groups who are at increased risk of HIV irrespective of epidemic type or local context. They include men who have sex with men, people who inject drugs, people in prisons and other closed settings, sex workers and their clients, and transgender people. Key populations often have legal and social issues related to their behaviors that increase vulnerability to HIV and reduce access to testing and treatment programs. In 2015, an estimated 44% of new infections occurred among key populations and their partners. There is no cure for HIV infection. However, effective antiretroviral, ARV, drugs can control the virus and help prevent transmission so that people with HIV, and those at substantial risk, can enjoy healthy, long and productive lives. It is estimated that currently only 70% of people with HIV know their status. To reach the target of 90%, an additional 7.5 million people need to access HIV testing services. In mid-2017, 20.9 million people living with HIV were receiving antiretroviral therapy, ART, globally. Between 2000 and 2016, new HIV infections fell by 39%, and HIV-related deaths fell by one-third, with 13.1 million lives saved due to ART in the same period. This achievement was the result of great efforts by national HIV programs supported by civil society and a range of development partners. The human immunodeficiency virus, HIV, targets the immune system and weakens people's defense systems against infections and some types of cancer. As the virus destroys and impairs the function of immune cells, infected individuals gradually become immunodeficient. Immune function is typically measured by CD4 cell count. Immunodeficiency results in increased susceptibility to a wide range of infections, cancers and other diseases that people with healthy immune systems can fight off. The most advanced stage of HIV infection is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, AIDS, which can take from 2 to 15 years to develop depending on the individual. AIDS is defined by the development of certain cancers, infections, or other severe clinical manifestations. The symptoms of HIV vary depending on the stage of infection. Though people living with HIV tend to be most infectious in the first few months, many are unaware of their status until later stages. The first few weeks after initial infection, individuals may experience no symptoms or an influenza-like illness, including fever, headache, rash, or sore throat. As the infection progressively weakens the immune system, an individual can develop other signs and symptoms, such as swollen lymph nodes, weight loss, fever, diarrhea, and cough. Without treatment, they could also develop severe illnesses such as tuberculosis, cryptococcal meningitis, severe bacterial infections and cancers such as lymphomas and Kaposi's sarcoma, among others. HIV can be transmitted via the exchange of a variety of body fluids from infected individuals, such as blood, breast milk, semen and vaginal secretions. Individuals cannot become infected through ordinary day-to-day contact such as kissing, hugging, shaking hands, or sharing personal objects, food or water. Behaviors and conditions that put individuals at greater risk of contracting HIV include having unprotected anal or vaginal sex, having another sexually transmitted infection such as syphilis, herpes, chlamydia, gonorrhea, and bacterial vaginosis, sharing contaminated needles, syringes and other injecting equipment and drug solutions when injecting drugs, receiving unsafe injections, blood transfusions, tissue transplantation, medical procedures that involve unsterile cutting or piercing, and experiencing accidental needle stick injuries, including among health workers. Serological tests, such as RDTs or enzyme immunoassays, EIAs, detect the presence or absence of antibodies to HIV-1/2 and or HIV-P24 antigen. No single HIV test can provide an HIV-positive diagnosis. It is important that these tests are used in combination and in a specific order that has been validated and is based on HIV prevalence of the population being tested. HIV infection can be detected with great accuracy.